Hey, this is Deepak here from digitaldeepak.com, and in today's video we are going to talk about a very important concept that is changing the face of digital marketing, and it has been very prominent recently. So today we are going to talk about native advertising and sponsored content. So you might have heard about native advertising here and there, and you might know what sponsored content is, but in this video we will delve deep into it and see how it is actually changing the face of digital marketing. So basically what Wikipedia says is that native advertising is a type of advertising, mostly online, that matches the form and function of platform upon which it appears. So if you have heard or if you have seen the statistics, basically when it comes to internet advertising, which basically started with banner advertising, nowadays most people don't click on banners because banners are obviously ads which you don't want to consume. But publishers do have to place advertisements, otherwise they cannot get paid for publishing that content in the first place. So most of the publications are now freely accessible online, whether it is YouTube or whether it is a blog, but there has to be some form of earnings for the publisher so that they get paid for the efforts that they are putting in, otherwise it is not going to be sustainable. But problem is that most of the advertising now is very prominent and people ignore it. So there is something called banner blindness. So people just don't click on banners anymore. They just see the banner and they don't even look at what's written in the banner. And there are statistics which say that only 10 out of 1,000 people actually, you know, click on a banner, or sometimes it's as low as 1 or 2 out of 1,000 people who see the banner who actually click on the banner. So to combat this, what has happened is that many advertisements have started seeping into normal content, trying to behave as if they are normal content in the first place. So right now we are going to focus more on sponsored content and advertising online, but when you look at magazines in, you know, even now, but you might have read magazines a while back, you might have seen that certain pages are actually looking like articles or content, but they are actually ads. So here you can see that in a magazine, there is an ad for a Adidas shoe, but it looks like an article, but it's actually an ad. And in a corner, they just mark it as advertorial. So here you can see it's called advertorial. And overall, the basic premise is to kind of trick the user into believing that it's an article, but also kind of give a disclaimer that no, this is sponsored. But the fact that it's a sponsored one, or it's the fact that it's an ad, is kind of hidden, and kind of hidden as much as possible from the user, right? So even when you look at publications such as Your Story, so Your Story does a lot of native advertising and sponsored content. So here you can see sponsored post is what they have given. So certain publications are kind of very ethical and they say that this particular post is sponsored, but many publications do not disclose it exclusively. For example, if you are reading a magazine and if it clearly states that a particular article is a sponsored post, you are less likely to read that particular article, because if it is not published by the merit of journalism, you know, if it is not published because it's an interesting article, but because someone paid to put that article right there, then you are not going to read that article, right? So that's what we are looking at. And when you look at online types of sponsored content and native advertising, mostly even when you look at search engine ads, they are some form of native advertising because you are searching for something, but they also make sure that you get ads, and these ads are somewhat useful, but these ads come up in the top because someone is paying for it. Then you have recommendation widgets, which we are going to talk about today. So if you have read news websites, below the content of these news you can see that from around the web, and you can see many links being placed there. Then you have sponsored content, and then you have promoted listings and a lot of different things like that. And even sponsored content that you see on Facebook feed, in your Facebook feed, is also some form of native advertising, because it's just in a corner, it says sponsored post, and it doesn't really kind of stand out as a banner, which is an ad, right? So people in general want to ignore ads, but sometimes you just look at the Facebook feed, you just consume the content, you just read because there is something in the news feed, and then you realize that it's an ad. So recently I stumbled upon this video by John Oliver, And he has explained about this entire concept of native advertising and how it actually impacts journalism and content consumption. So this is something that you should take a look at. I have given a link to this YouTube video below this video or wherever you are consuming this from, and or you can just go ahead and search on YouTube about it. So I also want to show you product placements. So product placements are basically a form of native advertising which doesn't look like advertising in the first place. Like for example, if you have seen this series called TVF Pictures, so TVF, media company from Mumbai, made this series called TVF Pictures, and it's basically a story of a startup or a story about bunch of guys trying to start up and trying to raise money. And obviously India is abuzz with the startup scene, and they made a TV series about it, and they have got like millions of views. You can see that the first episode got like 5.4 million views, and this is their most famous TV series that they have launched. So this TV series, they have not launched it on Netflix or they have not launched it on TV with ads in between. What they have done is that they have actually launched it on YouTube itself for free. But how did they earn money, or how did they make money out of this, or how did they get money in the first place to go ahead and create this TV series? You can go ahead and check this particular Quora post, which asks who are the sponsors for TVF Pictures. So basically it's a product placement. So Ponds Men, Uber and Kingfisher are the sponsors, and basically it appears as product placement. It doesn't appear as ads in between the TV series, but it appears during the show. Like here you can see that this guy is washing his face and there is Ponds Men's cream, and this guy is booking an Uber cab on his phone. And whenever there is a scene where they are going to a bar and having alcoholic drinks, you can see that Kingfisher is basically the brand which is placed there. So this kind of advertising kind of psychologically impacts you, you know, kind of connects the dots. So you think that it's basically a product placement, and for them it helps in boosting the brand when they do it. So these are product placements, again a form of native advertising. And there is a movie called The Truman Show, which you should definitely watch. And this entire movie is based on native advertising and sponsored content. So basically, Jim Carrey, when he is born, he is actually born into a show, and his entire life is part of a show, and people just keep watching this particular show, and 24/7 this show keeps running and basically tracks the life of Jim Carrey from being a kid to being a big adult. And it's a very interesting movie which you should definitely see. And this particular TV show, they make money by doing product placement. So I will show you a video here. So basically in this particular show, you can see that Jim Carrey is there, and Jim Carrey's girlfriend comes home, and then she is talking to Jim Carrey.
Look what I got for you at the checkout. It's a chef's pal. It's a Dicer Gravy Grater Peeler Orange Juice. It's
So you can see that it's just part of the movie, and in this movie Jim Carrey doesn't even know that he is actually part of this grand scheme of native advertising and this actual show called The Truman Show. That's the that's what the movie is about. And this particular character actually shows a product, and this is how they make money. So that's how the movie is based on. So this is native advertising and sponsored content. And if you watch John Oliver's video, you can actually get a lot of insights about how it's actually changing the entire publishing industry. So people have started losing trust on publications, and even he kind of recently found out that even New York Times does this. So New York Times recently published this article about women in prison, but it's actually a sponsored post by Netflix to promote their show. So if you know about this Netflix show called Orange is the New Black, it's basically a show about women in prison or something like that. And New York Times did a feature about it, and it's sponsored by Netflix. Right. So this kind of native advertising basically kind of harms journalism, because let's say if I start promoting products by, you know, getting money from these brands, and just promoting it to my audience without clearly telling whether it's a sponsored ad or whether it's something that I truly recommend, then you would lose trust on me, right? So that's how the entire industry is changing, and this is basically native advertising. So let's go ahead and talk a little bit about sponsored content. So right now, sponsored content is also a form of native advertising, because people cannot always clearly differentiate whether it's an ad or whether it's an whether it's content from the publication itself. Like, for example, if you browse through Hindu, you can see that there is a section called From Around the Web, and these are looking like these are articles from the Hindu itself, and that's why people click on it. But these are actually articles from outside the web. So if you actually click on it, it goes out, and you can see it's paid.outbrain.com. So basically, Outbrain is a content recommendation engine which I have also started experimenting with recently. And eventually what will happen is that people will lose trust, because they know that this particular section is paid ads, and these are not actually content from this publication itself, right? So they have 9 different links which actually point to some other ad link, and they have only 3 links which are actually articles within Hindu itself. So it's a very bad combination. I would say that if there are like 3 links on the top from within the publication and 3 links which are like linking to advertisers post, then it's a good balance. But still people click on it because they think they are content from inside, right? They don't think they are actually ads. So Outbrain is one of the quality networks around, and Outbrain allows only content pages to be promoted on their network. They don't allow landing pages or direct pages which can be published on their network. So you can see that what I have tried recently is that I have tried to drive traffic to my own blog post using Outbrain, and here you can see there are 2 different blog posts that I have started promoting, and let's say past 7 days, last week, let me take the statistics. You can see that I have been driving around 700 visitors a day, 400 visitors a day, and these visitors come at a very low cost, as low as 4 cents a click, 5 cents a click, and this is after they have very low CTR. Like here you can see that it's 0.04%, here it's 0.05%, but still Outbrain can drive traffic to these posts. So these links basically appear on other publications below their articles, and they drive traffic. So you can see Bloomberg is using another network called Taboola. So you can see here sponsored links by Taboola. So here you can also, just like any other ad, you can have retargeted ads, you can have articles, you can have landing pages as well. So Taboola allows landing pages, Outbrain does not allow landing pages. So I have been trying to run a campaign on Taboola as well, and I tried to drive traffic directly to my landing page, and obviously the conversions were very low because they were not very targeted as much as Facebook ads. So there are other such content recommendation networks as well, like Gravity, Columbia, Rev Content, and things like that. So sometimes for some advertisers, I have heard that it works. Like, for example, someone in the finance industry trying to get the interest of people. So this is what content recommendation engines is all about, and we discussed about native advertising. Definitely go ahead and watch this particular video. Just search for it on YouTube. And if you have any comments about native advertising, or if you have any questions, just leave a comment below. So thank you for watching this video, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.